YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Yeah, the earth is ringing like a bell. There was several large earthquakes near Fiji. Here on Google Earth, you can see we got the South New Hebrides Trough. We got the Lau Ridge. These were really deep earthquakes, almost 400 miles below sea level. And then also we got the Tonga Ridge over here, which is subducting. Then it comes back up, probably close to the Lau Ridge. And you can see the little arrow up over here, I hope, the direction that this whole plate, this whole area is moving. Going to Google Earth here, you can see we got Australia over on the left. We got the Tonga Trench. Let's zoom in there. They got six earthquakes listed within the last 24 hours. Started out with a magnitude 4.9. Let me bring that down for you. 394.8 miles. And as you know, any earthquake could be a foreshock for something much larger. All right, so we got, oh, actually before that was a 6.8. That was 390 miles below sea level. And then we got a 7.0, 413 and a half miles below sea level. You know, they used to think that earthquakes down there in the mantle didn't happen. Okay, then we got a 6.6. A 5.1, and more recently they reported a 4.9, 405 miles below sea level. And we got the Fiji Basin here. Here we have different helioplots. Yeah, these are the earthquakes. This is Alaska. We got Oregon, Disney World down there in Florida, Hawaii, South Dakota, Pennsylvania, let's bring it down some more, Indiana, Tennessee, Arizona, Michigan, yeah, everything just, yeah, the earth is ringing. We also have Barbados, I'm getting all tongue-tied, Panama, Grand Turk, let's see, Dominican Republic, Honduras, China. Yeah, several from China. Just really, like I said, it's just shaking and shaking. Yeah, there's a lot that data is not available. Alaska, Turkey, St. George, Antarctica, Missouri. Yeah, let's go on. Florida, Philippines. Ethiopia doesn't show, does it? Armenia. Look at that. Texas. Another idea of what was happening during the earthquake. You can see here how, the fault line moved going northwest a little bit. And it also dropped down. Subduction. Until today, the largest earthquake that was in this location was earlier this year, February 16th, right there. And that one was fairly deep too. 535 kilometers. Yeah. Closer to, the trench over here. Yeah, there's always lots of fairly large earthquakes, but nothing really that big. Well, there's a 7.4. When was that? That was last year, March 4th. You know, I talked about the weakening of our magnetic field, how we're going to see more and more of these large earthquakes. Yeah, they say how our jet stream is broken, because as our Earth's magnetic field weakens, yeah, it even affects our weather. They don't want to tell you that is the reason for the increase in earthquakes and volcanic activity. And all this adverse weather and earthquakes in diverse locations. Yep, so it's moving. Let's bring this out. Where can we expect some of this pressure probably to go? Over here. Yeah, along the Hunter Fracture Zone. And yeah, they'll have more earthquakes over there, more than likely. Yeah, and then they got this piece of the Australian plate that broke off. That's slowly moving over here. Yeah, towards the Fiji Islands. The largest quake that I have here was in 2018. That was a magnitude 7.9. That one, too, was really deep. 670 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 416 miles, close to what's been happening today. Just showing you guys another reason you need to be prepared for any type of disaster. So many people think the government's going to come and bail them out. So used to all these free handouts. Nope, you're going to be on your own. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.